Human trafficking, forced labor, people living and working as modern-day slaves, paid next to nothing.
A federal grand jury indictment reveals a heartbreaking case right here in Kansas City.
KMBC 9's Maria Antonia spoke to a man who says he first witnessed it years ago.
A man who worked in that Westport building you see behind me, the same building where Giant Labor Solutions, GLS for short, had an office. GLS, according to federal investigators, was at the center of the criminal enterprise. Down a basement hallway next to the GLS office the feds busted was a private investigation agency. This is where the man we talked to worked.
I've led an interesting life, having been a police officer and undercover for the federal government and being a PI.
Those are among the reasons he wants his identity concealed as he talks of what went on inside the GLS door.
It was rotten.
They covered that narrow glass window, he adds, but when the men first brought women in, he heard things.
It was obvious that they were engaged with one another physically.
He wanted to get a better handle.
I got nosy and started looking around to see what was going on exactly.
He says he often saw this man. Like most of the defendants, he's from Uzbekistan, described by authorities as the enterprise leader.
I did notice that after they were here about 2 to 3 months, they all had new cars, Mercedes, etc.
He also talks about getting to know some of the people GLS is accused of bringing to the U.S. illegally to work at places like area hotels. Workers, authorities say, were paid a fraction of the funds GLS would receive from the hotels and other clients for the labor. And if a worker dared question GLS heads about wages,
they would yell at these people, just scream at them if they came in with a problem. If, you know, I only made $2 this week, and they would just belittle them.
Other windows into the workers' lives were apparently open to him.
The couple told me where they lived, so I went over there, and there were 11 of them living in a one-bedroom apartment at Union Hill. They were paying Giant Labor Solutions $150 a month each for the apartment.
Seems they couldn't even get mail. Authorities say the enterprise also controlled that part of their lives.
I feel horrible for them.
Other witnesses showed us this website they say GLS used to describe its happy, appreciative employees as 100% legal, even displaying a U.S. Department of Labor and Homeland Security seal. The man we spoke to says he tipped the feds in 02 or 03.
Called my contact and alerted him to what was going on and said, you need to look at this because it's not right.
The defendants accused in this indictment of making at least $6 million off workers employed not just locally but in 14 states were shut down in May of this year.
I was elated. I was really happy that they finally got him.
Neither GLS nor the man we talked to are in that building now. He left the private eye business and our area is retiring to another country because he says when you do what he did, you make a lot of enemies. Back to you.
Thanks, Maria. Four of the 12 defendants in the human trafficking case fled the U.S. Authorities took statements from workers, but people in that Westport building say they still see some workers come in looking to get paid by GLS, unaware the operation is shut down.